Today I'm going to revise the journal. Okay, I given the question, so we'll start. So about GST, we said now. Okay, journal we will do. So first one, Rajkumar started a business with cash. Journal entries in the books of which one? Rajkumar only. So you have to write journal. So here, first one, April 1st, Rajkumar started business with cash, rupees 2 lakh, building rupees 2 lakh, and borrowed loan from Rakesh 50,000. So this is which entry? Opening entry. Okay, opening entry. So how to do this one? Anyone? Journal entry for that. So normally Rajkumar started a business with the cash. So cash account to capital. Here started a business with the cash, building and loan from Rakesh. So January. Karthik?
Cash account debtor, building account debtor. To Rajkumar's capital.
To loan from Rakesh. Rakesh is loan is liability. So asset debit, liability credit. So 1st April 2019. Okay. So we will write the amount. Cash 2 lakh. Building 2 lakh. Loan from Rakesh, 50,000. Cash account, it is an opening journal entry. So if any opening journal entry is there, asset debit, liability credit, then the balance amount will be capital. The balance amount will be capital. Balance amount will be capital. Your cash is how much you want to? Cash, okay. 2 lakh. So 4 lakh. So to Rajkumar's capital. Four lakh minus 50,000. 3 lakh 50,000. Okay. Being started business with cash. Started business with the cash, building and loan. Okay, it is an opening entry. Opening entry, assets, debit, liability, credit. Balance figure is capital. Next one. 4th April, deposited cash into Dana Bank. Dana Bank deposited cash into Dana Bank. Anila, generally rupees 50,000.
Cash account debtor to bank
account. Personal account. Bank is personal account. Debit the receiver, credit the giver. Here you look, bank is a receiver or giver.
Bank account debtor to.
So entry will be Dana Bank account debtor. Otherwise, bank account debtor to cash account. Dana Bank account debtor to cash account. Being deposited cash into bank. Deposited cash into bank. deposited cash into bank 50,000. Okay, first it is opening entry, second one deposited cash into then a bank, bank account to cash. So next one, purchased computer from Brijesh of rupees 13,000, 18% GST and paid by check. Okay, so which one? Purchased computer and GST 18% and paid by check. Okay, that is the journal. So journal we have to write. If you purchased computer, we know that computer account to here bank. So computer account debtor, but GST is there. So input GST. So here we have to pay. So input CGST account debtor, input SGST account debtor to through bank. So to bank account, our bank is Dana Bank, to Dana Bank, that you can write to Dana Bank account, being purchased computer at the rate of 18% GST, 18% GST and paid by check. Computer account debtor, input CGST account, Central Goods and Service Tax. Then input SGST account. Okay, now how to write the amount? So we know that computer amount it is given 30,000. Computer amount is 30,000. So that you have to write computer. So here given 18% GST. So half to the central government, half for state government. So 30,000, we know that 30,000, 18%. So $5,400, that is total. So that divided by 2 means 9% to central and 9% to the state. So 2,700. Okay, it means 30,000 into 9%. Now we will give, we are purchasing computer. Selling time, we will get output CGST. Okay, so to bank account. So this much amount we have to give for the purchase of computer. Okay, computer account letter, input CGST account letter, input SGST account letter to bank account. To bank account. Next. Next, 10 cash sales. Cash sales. Jewelry. Femina, cash sales. Jewelry. 10. Date 10.
Cash to sales account.
Very good. Cash account to sales account. Being cash sale, it was sold goods for cash. $90,000. Next. Next, goods sold on credit to Ganesh, rupees 10,000 at 5% TD, trade discount. Goods sold on credit to Ganesh for rupees 10,000 at 5% TD. Anna, jewelry.
Good.
Ganesh account to sales account amount. If it is a TD is there, no need of writing discount, no entry. After deducting the amount, we have to write being sold goods on credit. So amount it is 10,000. So 10,000. 5% TD. So 9,500. If you purchase goods in bulk quantity, if you purchase of your sale in bulk quantity, we are giving discount. Otherwise, we are getting discount. Next one, good Ganesh returned goods of rupees 950. Ganesh returned goods of rupees 950. Anita, journal entry. First, we have to look whether any Ganesh transaction before this.
Sales return account debtor to Ganesh.
Yes, correct. Sales return account to Ganesh. Sales return account to Ganesh. Being sales return. Next. Eighteenth one. Goods. Goods taken by Rajkumar for his personal use. Goods taken by Rajkumar for his personal use. Tomlin Jewelry. Goods taken by Rajkumar. Rajkumar for his personal use.
Sir, drawing his account up to two. Capital account.
drawings account to capital account. No. To goods we drawn. So to to purchase. Okay. Suppose if you write goods withdrawn by the proprietor, then also correct. Okay. So instead of purchase, if you write goods withdrawn, that also no problem. To purchase account, amount 1000 being drawings of goods. Next one, paid telephone charges 500 and taxi fare 200. So we can make a compound entry, both paid only, which entry in which more than one debit and one credit, that is called a compound. Contra entry means entry it will come on the both side of the cash book. So what is entry? Compound entry. Which one? 20th one, Abarna. Paid telephone charges and taxi fare.
Sir, telephone charges account debtor, taxi yes. fare charges account debtor to cash account.
Yes. Telephone charges account debtor. Taxi fare account debtor to cash account 200. So total 700. Both it is debit only. Otherwise, if it is only another thing is received means separate entry you have to make. Suppose received interest, paid telephone charges same date and received interest. So first telephone charge account to cash, then cash account to interest being paid telephone charges and taxi fare. Next one, paid transport charges 5000 at 5% GST. Paid transport charges 5000. Paid transport charges 5000 and 5% GST. Karthik, try.
Transport charges account debtor.
Yes. Transport charges account debtor.
Input as GST account debtor.
Yes. Input CGST account debtor.
Input as GST account debtor.
Yes. Input SGST account debtor.
To cash.
To cash. So you tell the amount also. Transport charges
5000.
5000. So 5% GST. So
125.
Yes. Being paid transport charges including 5% GST. Next one. Paid audit fees 5,000 by check. By check. Basel journal entry. Paid audit fees rupees 5,000 by check. Paid audit fees by check. Basel. Are you there? Basil? Anit Jalandhari. Paid audit fees by check.
For audit.
Yes, audit fees accounted to?
Audit fees.
Being paid audit fees. Being paid audit fees. Next. Next. 26. Date 26. Purchase furniture 70,000 and amount paid by check at 12% GST. At 12% GST. Femina. Purchased furniture and amount paid by check at rate of 12% GST.
Sir, furniture.
Furniture account debtor.
Input CGST.
Yes, input CGST account debtor.
Input
yes.
SGST.
Input SGST. To here
bank account.
Oh yes,
bank account.
To bank account. Okay, so amount 70,000 into 12% so 4,200. So amount will be furniture 70,000. 4,200. So 78,400. Being furniture purchased. With 12% GST. Next one. Sold motor car worth rupees 1 lakh. At the rate of 18% GST and sales proceeds credited to our account, means to bank account. Okay, so sold motor car with 18% GST. Aparna, sold motor car with 18% GST through bank account only.
Sir, bank account debtor.
Correct. Bank account debtor.
To sales account.
To sales or which sold motor car. So what we have tried to?
Motor car account.
To motor car account.
To output CGST yes. account.
To output CGST account.
To output SGST account.
Yes. To output SGST account. So earlier we said lot of tax they are collecting government. Okay, what excise duty, service duty, service taxes. So lot of extra tax are there. So now everything it is coming in which one? Goods and service tax. So that is a journal entry. So being sold motor car being sold motor car at 18% GST. So we have to calculate the amount. So amount it is motor car amount sold motor car 1 lakh. 1 lakh is the amount. So motor car 1 lakh 18% 1 lakh 18% 18,000. Okay, 1 lakh 18% 1 lakh 18% 18,000. So half 9,000 half. So 1 lakh 18,000. So we'll get 1 lakh 18,000. Next, so normally after the end, what they will do? This output minus input, no? Purchasing time we paid some tax. Getting time we will collect tax from customer. So that we will deduct that the difference amount we will deposit with the government. That tax account to this account to bank. No entry for that. Now no need to make. Okay. Next, last. Paid cash to Kavita, rupees. 15,500. Who allowed us discount of rupees 500? Okay, paid cash to Kavita. How much amount? 15,500. Paid cash to Kavita 15,500. Who allowed a discount? So we paid 15,500. So we got discount. Which one? Who allowed us a discount 500? Means what? Correct 16,000 is the amount. Okay, correct 16,000 is the amount. So we paid through cash 15,500. So we got 500 discount. So generally, Anila, paid cash to. Paid cash to Kavita. And given discount also. So entry will be paid cash to Kavita, who allowed us discount. Kavita, Anila, entry. Kavita account debtor to cash account to discount account. Kavita account to cash to discount being paid to Kavita. Being paid to Kavita and discount received, and the discount received. Okay, so we paid amount is 15,500. So we got discount 500. So total 16,000. Suppose if it is given, sold goods to Kavita 15,500. Then we got a discount 500. Means in that case you have to write 15,000 cash discount 500. So 15,500. But here it is given paid amount is 15,500. So we got discount 500. So total amount will be 16,000.